My name is Jeff Lawson. I live in Wendell, North Carolina, and this is our 1932 Ford Highboy Roadster, and its name is Elrod. I've always liked 32 Fords. I've always been into cars since I was a kid. And I met a guy years ago, Chad Adams, Adams Rod Shop in Calhoun, Georgia. And I decided to have him build this car for me. He builds these from scratch. He does everything in-house, except for powder coat and chrome. So Chad and I sat down and we designed the car, basically cocktail napkin kind of sketch, picked colors and all that, and he built the car to fit me. Well, they call it a Highboy Roadster. As you can see, it's fenderless and topless and all that. And the story behind that is, back in the 40s and 50s, these cars were being hot rodded and raced, and weight is your enemy. So these young kids were stripping off the fenders, stripping off the hoods to make them lighter. So that's where this style of car came from, and I've always gravitated towards that simple stripped down look. So we built it to emulate the race cars from the 40s and 50s. It has a small block Chevy 350 by 300 horsepower, and a lot of people give me flack for having a Chevy motor in a Ford, but there's a history to that. These cars had flathead four-cylinder motors in them, and years ago, back in the 40s, well actually in the 50s, to get more horsepower, hot rodders were taking small block Chevy motors out of junkyards and putting them in these cars to get horsepower gain. So we built it in that 60s era style. So to be correct, we did a small block Chevy motor. This jacket, Chad finished the car in 2019. And it was debuted at the Street Rod Nationals in Louisville, Kentucky. And it was in the Coker tire booth. Coker is a company that makes vintage tires and vintage replica tires. And Street Rodder Magazine does Street Rod of the Year. They pick one car in the country that is the top, and they start that process by picking the top 100 cars. And they picked our car as the top 100, one of the top 100 cars in the country. They narrow it down then to a top 10, and then to Street Rod of the Year. So we didn't get down to top 10 or Street Rod of the Year, but we got in the top 100, and they sent us the jacket and they put the sticker on the car. So I was humbled and honored that, you know, this car that Chad put together for me actually made it in the top 100. They call these cars happy cars, and it's true. Everywhere you go, people are smiling and waving, and I wave back and have a good time. I don't care if you're driving a Honda tuner or a Rolls Royce. We're all car people, and we're all in the same hobby. So it draws a lot of attention. It's hard to put gas in it without spending a half hour at the gas station. You get a crowd every time.